Okay, I got a 1970 Mercury 550 horsepower outboard on this Boston Whaler. It's going to Idaho. It's now at sea level, and you got to change the jets to run it leaner at high altitude. And usually, you have to pull the carburetors out of the machine to change the jets. The upper jet is easy to get to, but the lower jet is pretty far down in there. You can see it behind that brass plug. Hard to get to, but I did a little modification and I'll show you how I did that. Okay, we're changing the jets in the engine here. This jet, you see that jet? That's a 0.063 jet. Gas jet. This engine's going to Idaho. It needs a 0.061. So if you look, the jets are in that hole right there. You can see the jet inside that carburetor hole right there. And the bottom jet, it's kind of hard to get to. It's down there. So what I did was I drilled a hole through the bottom of the case, and you can look right in there and you can see that jet. Now, I've got to get the jet out of there. I've unscrewed it, and I've got a special tool that I'll show you here in a second. Now, to get to that bottom jet, I put a socket on the end of my extension, and I unscrew. I put the rag underneath there in case you drop the plug that goes on the outside of the jet cover. Gently remove it, and that's the outside plug that covers the jet. And now, as you can see, I can unscrew my jet with a screwdriver, and I'll pull it out with my special tool. What you do, you take a long screwdriver and you put it through the hole, and you unscrew the jet. Okay, the jet's now loose. I already did it to this upper jet. He's already been installed and he's ready to go. Now I'll get my special tool. We'll get that jet out of there without dropping
it.
This
is my special tool. It's a welding rod with a toothpick, pointed toothpick, taped on the end.
And what you have to do is insert the welding rod in there and press it into the hole in the, there you can see I've got the jet on the end of that, and I got to bring it out through the hole very gently. And there's the low altitude jet. And I'll insert the new jet in just the same. You can see the main fill jet for the high altitude is the 061. It comes with a gasket. The jets I took out didn't have a gasket behind them, but it seemed to run fine. But I'm going to put these in with a gasket. Okay. I'm going to insert my new jet through the hole that I bored in the cowl in. Try to get it in the hole. There. Perfect. Okay, I'm gonna insert my screwdriver through the hole. And tighten the jet into the threads. Now, I'm just going to tighten up that cap screw. I don't want to tighten it too tight. Okay, I'm going to install the top cap screw. It just screws in a hole and covers up that main jet threaded area. There we go. Top one is now in too. If you look at the bottom jet, you see an open thread there. That's for another carburetor attachment. But that hole's just open, there's nothing goes in there. Now that I've got the jets in, all that's left to do is put the front cover plate on. It's got the switch box. I've got all the wires hooked up. Looks like a mess, but it's really not too difficult after you've done it once or twice. So, got the choke to hook up again, and we should be ready to go. Water's hooked up. Hit the choke button. I'm going to have to see what happens. Success. Now what I'm going to do is just only thing I don't know is how much to run it at below 4,000 feet with those high altitude jets. Might be too lean down here, so I'm just going to let her sit till we get to Idaho.